Okay, thank you very much. And thank you very much for inviting me and giving this opportunity to talk about our project. And as you can see, that this project has started a little more than 1 year ago. And it is a five and a half year project. So we just spent it nearly 1 year, and we'll have about a little bit more than 4 years to go. So this talk is partly of our achievement so far, but mainly it is a kind of plan. So I like to have maybe your opinions or your request about doing scientific paper analysis. And most of the members in our project has NLP background. And initially, this project actually started from a small collaboration within our institute. And NICE is a kind of university, but we have only graduate course schools. And we have three graduate schools. One is information science, our school, and the other two are biological science and material science. And actually, we started some collaboration with them, and their main request was to analyze scientific papers, because publication size of those areas, biological science, material science, is actually much bigger than on our field. Okay, so the objectives, actually, I've involved in kind of similar project for last maybe 15 years about analyzing PubMed or analyzing technical papers. But recently, NLP research actually progressed in analyzing text. So we thought that it was doing or kind of repeated work on analyzing scientific papers. Okay, so first, because we have NLP background, so we like to develop and deepen our text and document analysis technologies, implementing various tools. And the so of course, we like to implement some document retrieval and recommender system, and it is based on the similarity at various aspects. Okay. And also, we like to do some knowledge extraction, and by doing that, we like to make some summarization of not only single document, but of number of documents to show the result as a visualization system or producing some survey. And all of those development will be done through various levels of structural similarity we're going to define related with document. Okay. And this is on the overall here with the project, and we have a lot of methods on the upper level, and we like to analyze document at the inner document level and inter document level. And by inner document level, we mean that document analysis and the consideration extraction, predictive argument structure analysis, and event chain. And by doing that, we like to make some structure analysis of document. And by inter-document analysis, we are talking about citation and similarity between documents. Okay, and those are the people involved in our project. And my group is group zero, which is the people in NICE. And those are the people. And actually, Aida San, who gave the introductory talk in this morning, she's also involved in that. Her group is actually working on analyzing PDF structure of the text, because nearly 80% of the technical papers at the moment are produced by PDF. And it is not a trivial work to extract information from PDF, especially not only text, but the figures, tables, and graphs, and captions, and in some cases, footnotes are actually mixed into a text. So actually, complete system of extracting such information doesn't exist at the moment. Okay, so there are some other people, but mainly I'm going to talk about the activities in our group. Okay, and the method we are doing is first document analysis, and sorry about this. Okay. Okay, but so this is mainly about the inner document analysis, and we like to analyze document structure, and this is actually citation type analysis, and of course entity extraction and also relation between entities, and entity can be described as an event, and there can be some event chain like a causality relationship. Okay, and the another topic we are actually working on is domain-dependent research paper structure. Because at the moment, we are working on document structure, paper structure, by a kind of uniform format and a very shallow structure. But for each domain, okay, so I will talk about this later. And the key concept, I see. Okay, thank you. Okay. Okay, this slide seems same as previous one. Maybe I failed to, okay. I erased the correct one. Okay, but anyway, we are now working on the definition of similarity at various levels. Okay, so the various levels, okay, this is not the correct one. The various levels of similarity, we are talking about word level similarity, or maybe entity level similarity, or relation level similarity, or structure level similarity. Maybe I will be talking about this in the later section of my talk. Okay, and the so, as for the knowledge extraction, we are actually collaborating with some people in our institute, and the one professor is actually constructing the database called Knapsack database. It is actually the database which describes the relationship between plant and metabolite. So it's a very simple database, but each line consists of the name of plant and the name of metabolite it produces, and the link to the paper, which is actually the, in which the, this fact is actually described. And the size of the database is about 100,000 lines. Okay, that means they have actually almost manually extracted those information from scientific literature. And that professor said that for the last 10 years, they are not so active. So there are a lot of information which is actually kept in the scientific literature, but are not included in the database. So we can use the existing database as a kind of supervised data for extracting new information from the nearly recently published papers. And the similar thing happens in this database, CLIC database. It is a database produced by a professor at Kyoto University, and this is a kind of relationship between protein-protein. By an enzyme or something like that. And the structure of this database, is quite similar. Okay, for each interaction, there is an enzyme, and the two proteins are actually related. Okay, and they are constructing the kind of pathways. Okay, and for each protein-protein interaction, the original papers are actually linked. Okay, so we can also use those information as supervised data to extract new information. Okay, and also we are working on the material science people, and in this specific field, they are interested in some electric elements, the device that produces electricity from the difference of temperatures. Okay, and they are interested in the properties described in the paper. Okay, and so we cannot construct the large size of annotated data, but in some cases, for instance, in this field, they haven't got any database already constructed. So we inevitably need to do some data annotation. Okay, so we are also constructing annotation tools for papers, and I will talk about this later. But we try to use several tools for data annotation, like a BLAT or Webern, but because the extraction of text part from the PDF document is not correct enough, because for each field, okay, there are a lot of different types of journals and conference papers, and each such publication has a quite different format. So there is no system, PDF analyzing system, which can successfully extract all the information from this kind of various types of PDF. So actually, when we try to use Web 1 tool, extracted text are in many cases corrupted. And we found that annotators usually not look at the annotation system, but they look at PDF printed text, and find useful information, then go to the annotation tool to make annotation. But in some cases, the words are actually read in an incorrect way, and that kind of annotation tool cannot has functionality to correct the erroneously read text. Okay. In some cases, sentence boundaries are incorrectly segmented. Okay. So we decided to implement a tool which directly annotate on PDF paper. Okay. So that the annotator can read PDF paper on the screen and do annotation directly on the paper. Okay, I will show you the demo at the end of this talk. Okay, so the text analysis tools, actually we are re-implementing all those tools, and recently we've implemented the neural network-based POS Tara, and now we are using the same technique to named entity chunking and sentence boundary detection. Okay. And the system starts from the character representation and to construct a word level tokens, and then they are represented as a word level representation, and the annotation is done. Okay. And by using this one framework, by using output of POS level, we can do named entity annotation, or we can go directly from this layer to named entity recognition level. Okay. Another tools we are constructing is kind of parser, but especially focusing on the coordinate structure, which is frequently found in the scientific literature. Okay. So this kind of expression are frequently found in scientific papers, and these expressions are connected by several ends, and by coordination, I mean the structure connected by coordination conjunction, like and, or as well as something like that. Okay. So actually, this expression includes this kind of four different descriptions, and analyzing this kind of structure correctly is actually important to extract the entities and especially relationship between the entities. Okay, so we have developed tools for annotate coordination structures. So in this case, and this is actually extracted from the not that scientific paper. Okay, the three oranges range are actually coordinated by just the comma, and this green ones are coordinated by the and appearing in the. So this is a typical nested coordinate structure. So what we are doing now for analyzing those structure is we are first developing the alignment program to find the sequence of words which looks to be similar, okay. Coordination structure actually aligns similar expression, okay. But there are a lot of ambiguities, okay. And also, if the structure we found on the corresponding structure, okay, the sentence can be divided into two simple sentences like those, okay. So what we like to find is good alignment with good syntactic structure. When we divide those coordinate structures into separate way, okay, we don't evaluate those ones separately, but we are actually augmenting our transition based dependency parsing to capture the goodness of the sentences, which is actually represented by those coordination structure. So when the coordination structure appears several times and some coordination structure has a nested structure, maybe possible potential number of text, okay, simple sentences are quite large. But still, our aim is to find out the best sentences or best coordination structure that covers better alignment and the better overall structure. Okay, we haven't implemented it, but we are now trying to actually implementing this part and implementing the algorithms that can capture the evaluation of those separated sentences. Okay. And the other structure analysis is actually we found that lengths of sentences in scientific papers are actually longer than those appearing in newspaper articles. And most of the parsers we have now are actually trained by the newspaper articles, sentences from newspaper articles like Pantry Bank, annotated Pantry Bank. Okay. So the when our students check the length of the sentence, they say that the average number of words in one sentence in Pantry Bank is around 17 or 18, but the average length of the sentence in the scientific paper is about 24 words or something like that. Okay, so that means those sentences in scientific papers include a lot of coordination structure, and also they tend to include complex syntax structure that involves more than one predicate. Okay. But actually, English language actually has a lot of various types of complex sentence structure analysis, but that they are not, number of them, a variety of them are not infinite. Okay, so we are trying to find out the kind of lexicons for expressing English content complex sentences, and also we are now trying to construct a dictionary that describes the multi-word expressions. This case, go through is one of the multi-word expression, which we need to treat this as a single verb. And also, even if actually connects two sentences to form the complex sentence structure. Okay, and even if it's another multi-word expression, we need to handle this as a single verb. So actually, at the moment, we are not sure about how this kind of lexicon is effective for get a better analysis, but at least by constructing this kind of lexicon and try to attach those expressions in the final analysis of sentences, we can get better representation of sentence structure. Okay, but so this is actually our own interest. Okay, and this is the second method about document structure analysis. And we actually starting from very top-down approach of document structure and going on to the deep details. And the most shallow structure analysis of paper looks to be kind of structured abstract. As you may know that there are a lot of journals that actually ask authors to write abstract in a structured way, like specifying background of the paper, objective of paper, method, and the results and conclusions, like in this format. Okay, so this could be a very good summary of the paper. Okay, but unfortunately, maybe 80% or 90% of the journals and especially in our field, no journals or international conference actually assumes this kind of structured abstract. Okay, So if we can construct or generate this kind of structured abstract from the older papers, then we can define a kind of similarity or dissimilarity between document. Okay, we can say that this document or two papers actually shares a common objective, but uses quite a different method. Okay, so in some cases, we're interested in the papers sharing the same objective, but applying a very quite different, dissimilar techniques. So by controlling the similarity and dissimilarity between those aspects, maybe we can implement a little bit more fine-grained approach of paper retrieval. Okay. And we are also analyzing the citation relations between document. Okay. So at the moment in our group, we are actually that simply using these three types. Okay, so when the paper refers to another, it is referring a paper as a kind of objective view or method view and others. And the, actually in the IsoSenses group, one of the people in that group actually working on citation classification in a positive citation, negative citation, or neutral citation. So we can define the citation relationship from the different aspect. But in our group, we are working on this aspect. Okay, so this is example of structured abstract. Okay, so when we are given a paper, maybe we can analyze abstract to form the structured abstract by classifying the sentences in the abstract. Okay, but unfortunately, in many cases, abstracts are not written in that way. Okay, and the ordering of the writings are different, and in some cases, important information is actually missing in the abstract. Okay, they may skip the writing the objective or method. Okay, so in some cases, we have to extract those useful information from the document. Actually, saying this is quite easy, but actually doing this is a little bit actually difficult. Okay, and we tested on how we can do the structuralized abstract. Okay, by preparing some annotated result, and this is one of the results we have when we do classification in the same domain. So there are a lot of biological, biomedical domain journal which employs structured abstract. Okay, so by using those structured abstract as a training data, and by using the same papers in the same domain, we can get the accuracy over 70% of classification. It is not very good, but still not so bad. And this case, this is a case when we use SVM. And this is a case when we use context convolution networks. I don't explain this in detail, but we use convolution network using not only the sentence itself, but using the information from previous and the following succeeding sentences. Okay, if we just use the current sentence, we couldn't get good result. But when we use contextual information, we got better result. Okay. And those ones are actually the way of representing words. Okay. So those words, those mean that we use biomedical domain papers to learn word representation. In this case, we use our papers in our field to learn word representation. But we found that random initialization and learning representation during training actually produces better result. Okay. But the problem is when we apply same system to NLP domain, because the biological domain and the NLP domains are actually quite different, okay, the performance has actually downgraded quite a lot. Okay. We could only achieve about 40%. Of course, the reason may be that we had a lot of different terminologies okay, different expressions in the different field. So we need to do some kind of domain adaptation for this purpose. Okay. Actually, we actually thought that domain adaptation could be done by applying word representation learning by mixturing the biomedical domain papers and the NLP papers. Okay. So this is the best. And we try to learn word representation by mixing the papers from both domains. But we couldn't get the better result than just using starting from medical domain. So there are a lot of things to do for this direction. Okay. So 40% accuracy is not at the moment. It's not usable at the moment. Other than that, we have done similar but a little bit different project, which we try to use represent the whole text part of the paper into objective method and others. And for doing that, we simply do okay. So I will not have enough time to explain the detail. So maybe this video summarizes our task. Okay. So at the moment we use the papers in our field. Okay. In our field, association called ACL actually accumulates most of the important papers in our field, and they put all the papers at the ACL anthology, and those data are freely usable. Okay. So we downloaded all the papers and tried to classify sections of the papers by using some keywords. Okay. And then we learned classifiers to classify sections by using title of the section and words using the sections. Okay. So by doing that, we can classify sections into object method and others. And during the classification, we try to learn the presentation of those sections so that the final representation is done by the kind of vectors. So in that case, we use vectors is 100 dimensionality. Okay. And the ideas after that is by classifying, also we classified the citation relationship by analyzing that which part of the paper the citation actually belongs to. Okay, if the sections are talking about objectives, okay, then the paper cited at that section should be related with objective. Okay, it may not be correct, but we simply assume that. And by trying to reanalyze the vector representation of objective part or method part of the sentence, if the papers are related with objective, we try to move those papers similar along the line of the objective. Okay, and the paper is cited as a method, we try to make those papers closer from the method axis. Okay. So by doing this kind of analysis, we skip that. We tested, we do very simple test. We collected those papers and asked five computer science students to annotate the relationship between papers at the object aspect or method aspect. Okay. So by doing that, we collected pairs of papers which are related in several aspects. Okay. And we applied several paper similarity analysis method to find out how they are similar by extracting the top 20 pairs. And the method we used for section representation and using functionality, and this means that this is a citation using citation information to remodify the word representation. And that method achieved the best. That means that in top 20s, 68% of the papers actually related, those papers actually related. Okay. So we developed the paper retrieval environment that extract a similar document. Okay. By putting some word, we can retrieve all the papers which include that word. And by picking some sentence, paper, we can list all the papers related with similar to this paper. And by clicking objective method, we can re-rank the papers based on the objective aspect and method aspect and other aspect. Okay. And by clicking the citation button, we can get all the papers cited from that paper. And actually, this figure shows two hops from the original paper. And I'm afraid that this is not so easy to see. Okay, so maybe we may need to better representation about how to represent the citation relationship between the papers. But this is just an initial implementation. Okay, and the okay, as I said, that we are actually working with some domain expert to extract entities and relationship. Okay, and we will just show you two systems. This is Knapsack database. Okay, so as I said, for each database there is a name of metabolite and the name of species and the papers which actually describes this relationship. And the CAKE database is this kind of pathway database where each node and each line actually shows some interaction. Okay. So, for instance, in this case, these relations are actually described in the this part of the paper. Okay, but so usually the conventional assumption and the method for extraction relation is one is a supervised method where the entry and relation mounted data actually exist and those data are used for in the kind of supervised machine learning algorithms. And recent approaches actually use recurrent neural networks with some attention or convolutional neural networks. But the assumption is that they need to annotate maybe a quite large number of data. And another way is bootstrapping, where the system starts with small seed data and alternatingly run patterns and entity pairs, okay, to extract new information. Okay. And those assumptions actually aiming at extraction of a kind of general relationship, kind of common sense, actually which are described in the various part of the existing text. But what we have to extract from the paper is actually the very new information, which is actually maybe written only once in a new paper. Okay, so one of the collaboration is how to fertilize those database. Okay, and those database has already have a lot of relationship and reference papers. Okay, so we can apply a kind of distant supervision. Because we can construct and train data automatically through automatic annotation of relations in the reference papers. Okay, it is not 100% correct, but because each of the element of the database say that there are actually relationship described in the paper, so we can find, we try to find description of those entities, and if we can find a sentence that include both entities, we may be able to assume that those are correct result. But of course, in some cases, it is wrong. But by using the database, we can construct this kind of pseudo training data. Okay. So So we are doing the automatic annotation. But of course, we need to evaluate the result. So we ask an expert to do this kind of manual annotation as well. Okay. So the so at the moment we are doing entity detection by doing distant supervision. That means that okay, for each line, let's say that they have species name and kind of metabolite. Okay, so if the paper includes that species name and the metabolite name, then that should be a correct part. Okay, so we can use those data as a kind of training data and apply CRF or CN-based named entity organizer. And for extraction of novel relationship, okay, it's a relationship holding between specific entries, okay, which are never found in the database. Okay, and the problem is, even if we use distant supervision, we only have positive examples. We don't have any negative example. And many machine learning techniques actually assume the existence of positive as well as negative example. Okay, so the method we are at the moment using is using structure similarity against existing examples, okay, by using k-nearest neighbor or rank class SVM. Okay. Before talking about our method, this is the examples we found in the data. Okay, first, this is a very easy case. Okay, so this metabolite has been isolated from the bulk of this one. Okay. And difficult cases is say that three new something were isolated from this one, and the first two was that one and that one. Okay. So although this is clearly described, I think this is a kind of difficult case of extracting those ones. And those examples are actually the not difficult one, but they include coordination structure. Okay. You can see that this is coordination structure, and the problem is this R actually means Maringanide R. And this one actually has coordinate structure here and another coordinate structure here. Okay, so there are actually six relationships between them. Okay, so the what we are trying to do is a similarity-based relation extraction. So we try to find a new fact by a structural similarity based on the representation learning at the word level, term level, relation level, and expression levels. And the if we have in some domain we have existing ontology or lexicon, but in another case we don't have any such resource. But if there is a ontology or lexicon, we may be able to use those resources as a kind of prior knowledge. So what we are doing now is, actually, we have a lot of existing information which is actually constructed using distant supervision. Okay, and by applying sequence similarity model or dependency tree similarity model, we can calculate how similar new expressions are against existing expressions. Okay, so by doing that, we can maybe able to rank the expressions from the plausible to non-plausible ones. And we may ask domain expert check that if the higher ranked expressions actually correct data or not. And those actually at the moment what we are planning to do. And the problem will be how we can train the sequential model to calculate similarity or a tree model to calculate similarity. Okay. The last one is annotation tool. Okay, I skip the explanation. Okay, so this is a snapshot of the tools where we can directly annotate the ranges and also the relationship between those ranges or entities and put relation labels. Okay. And so we can annotate entity and the relationship in this way directly on PDF paper. And also we can do some range annotation by doing that one. So that we can do that, okay, maybe you can tell that this part is a figure or this part is a footnote or something like that. Okay, so this is on the ongoing project, and part of those ones I've already explained. Okay. we are further doing sentence or section functionality analysis because we haven't got good enough result. Okay, and also I didn't talk about this, but the background objectives are actually the very shallow structure, which may apply to various domains. But for each domain, there are very domain specific structure. Like some domains are quite interested in, okay, how the experiment is done, and some domains are interested in what kind of data are used. So for each domain, we like to, semi-automatically learn the domain specific structure so that the similarity or dissimilarity between papers in that domain is actually evaluated on using that kind of automatically learned structure. Okay, and we are also trying to do information extraction from non-textual parts like tables or graphs. Okay, and also we are trying to implement a recommendation system papers. Okay, so this is a summary paper. Maybe I will skip explaining this one. Okay, thank you very much.